Hey guys, my name is Simsy, how are you all doing? Welcome back to some more Total War Warhammer 2. Here today, I'm going to be starting episode 4 of my Mortal Empires Steel and Faith overhaul campaign as Clan Mors. We're playing as Queek, as the Skaven. Here today, we're going to have the Siege of Karaz-Karak. Karaz-Karak burns, and this is potentially the finale. So guys, if you want to see more Queek episodes on the channel, feel free to leave the video a like, show your support. I am open to do more episodes. However, we can sort of end the series here if we want. So I'll put a pin in the campaign if this video gets a decent amount of likes, comments, suggestions, and just general feedback and consensus, I will do more episodes. If not, we'll just simply move on to something else. So in the last episode, if you haven't gone and watched it, highly recommend you do. We managed to eliminate Queen Calidia just in the north here, adding her skull to the trophy rack. In episode 2, we managed to defeat Skarsnik and the Crooked Moon here in the pass. And then we took, obviously, Karak Eight Peaks. We currently have 5 territories at the moment in the sort of center here. Further in the south, Granite Massif is currently under the control of the Court of Labaris. And Karak Zorn has now actually pushed into our own territory there. Interesting. So we've consolidated up a decent amount, and I've made the decision to push upon the Mountain King's stronghold. It's a very quite ambitious and daring Queek thing to do, I think. So looking at the Silver Road, Mount Squighorn is under the control of Ziflin, I think that is. Is it Ziflin? Karak Kadrin, rather. And the Pillars of Grundy are actually under the control of the Greenskins. Rights-wise, we did go down our engineer. We've sailed him around. Tech-wise as well, we've unlocked the Furious Plans here. We've managed to unlock rank, income, melee attack as well. Diplomacy-wise, we're currently at war with Thorgrim Grudgebearer now, trying to take Karaz-Karak. They have 16 territories, the dwarves. They still don't want a peace treaty. Unfortunately, I've sent my Skaven engineer to the luscious lands of Lustria, and we found Skrulk and his domain. So he's got a couple territories here further in the east. Clan Pestilence currently has 6 settlements. I was trying to get a confederation with him, that would be ideal, but it's going to take some time to do that. He does, however, have a military alliance with Luther Harkon, the Mad, the Pirate of the Vampire Coast, essentially. And who is Skrulk still at war with? 2 lots of Lizardmen, 3 lots. Ah, he's at war with... not Tyrion, Teclis, and the followers of Nagash. Oh, okay. Regardless, in today's episode... Oh, we actually went past the Galleon's graveyard. Wow, okay. We made our way that way. Okay, cool. I hadn't actually seen it on the Grand Campaign. Okay, well, we're going to have the Siege of Karaz-Karak here today. We currently have 5 units of Storm Vermin Halberds, 4 units of Storm Vermin Sword and Shield. We currently have 7 units of Rat Ogres, 2 units of Claw Play Catapult. Further in the south, in my recruitment zone of Karak 8 Peaks, we managed to get our catapults and whatnot. We also have another full stack here as well with Warp, who has 5 units of Skaven Slaves, and then some swords as well, and some slingers, and 1 unit of his own Rat Ogres. So let's have the battle for Karak 8 Peaks here today, and hit our short campaign conditions, as I would say, because we can really leave this sort of open-ended. Oh, wow, we're heavily unfavored to win that. Oh, come on, Steelbeard. We're coming up against 2 units of Hammers, 1 unit of Slayers, 4 units of Longbeards, 1 unit of Longbeards with great weapons, 3 units of Dwarven Warriors, 1 Ranger, 2 Thunderers, and 2 Quarrelers, 2 units of Grudge Throwers. We're going to be able to eliminate them with our menace below. We're going to try and hit them to our max. If they had a lot more quarrelers, I would be worried, and a significant amount of cannons. But Skaven in Total War Warhammer order resolve are usually quite bad. Playing them actually on the field of battle is far better. So yeah, guys, if you want to see more Clan Maul's content on the channel, just leave the video a like and a comment. And depending on the support, we can do more episodes or we can move on to something else. It's completely up to you guys. Doesn't necessarily have to be Warhammer 2. Just has to be a strategy game, of course. If you haven't got to check down my Malekith series, I do recommend it. And I'll put all in the description below the mods if you guys would like to download and start your own Steel and Faith Overhaul modded campaign along with me. Okay, guys, welcome to the Siege of the Mountain King. Oh my god, look at this. Karak Kadrin will be Skaven. Alright, let's start the deployment now, shall we? Our first time with actually plague catapults as well. Okay, so, should we go with Storm Vermin up the top? No, let's not do that. So let's quickly drop our siege equipment, and let's go with proper sword and shield Storm Vermin, rather. Okay. So let's get our battering ram to go straight up through the guts. We'll pull you this side, and we'll probably let's pull you there. Okay, then we'll get we'll try and break everyone else up. Okay, so we'll go to about here, say. Try and drag you out as far as we can. Perfect. We'll leave it at that. Let's put my rat ogres in the secondary line. And then we have warp coming in as well. Okay, so what I want to do with my warp fire thrower, these guys are incredibly accurate. So what I want to do is actually aim for the gateway here. It's been incredibly successful in the past. You can get it down to at least 30-40% before the battering ram even gets up there. It increases the capturing time of the walls, which reduces arrow fire as well. So what I want you to do with this warp thrower, we want to... Actually, let's try and make this a bit better. So probably put you like here, say. I want you to focus on the towers to eliminate them as quickly as possible. And then we'll move you like here, say. And we'll move you here as well. Perfect. Well, let's have a look at our Skaven host. So here are our halberds here. Storm Vermin, very strong. Rat Ogres, keen and raring to go at the back. We have our catapults here. Siege Tower, Battering Ram as well. And then Queek Head Taker, already adding Skarsnik and Queen Kalidia on the back there. It is said that if you touch his trophy rack, you lose your hands. So I'm sure we're going to be adding more Dwarven skulls and hands to the trophy rack here today. Alright, let's start the battle then. Quickly pause and give out the orders. So, Battering Ram, push on this. Get my Lightning Cannon to focus on this as well. Move you here, say. And we'll probably redirect you there. Alright, let's get my Storm Vermin up and over the top, ready to go. So push like this. You're already pushing there, that's fine. And no one's pushing here because I'm getting you to push there. Okay, so where's this other Storm Vermin? So you can probably push around like that side. That would be ideal. And then maybe push you here, say. And then you here. Keep the Storm Vermin at the back, fine. We'll allow my catapults to fire upon their fort tower. And let's go. Let's go, 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 gadget. So here are the mighty dwarves holding Thorgrim Grudge Belt. Thorgrim Grudge Bearer's Domain. Okay. So here is the white dwarf. Ah! Longbeard's further at the back as well. Alright, so let's get ready. So they're starting to put their artillery fire on me, which can be a bit of a problem. Okay, so my reinforcements are now coming in. We need to get them up quick, fast. Like, we need these Sklaven. I like that word. Oh, there's like a doom wheel in the center of it. I didn't realize that. Oh, that's awesome. Okay, so they do have their own catapults at the back. I'm inclined to get rid of them quick, fast, before they start even firing upon us. So we'll send through some of our menace from below to try and disrupt their catapults quick, fast. If we could eliminate them, that would be perfect. They do have some of their own slayers further at the back. We need to slow things down because the Skaven have a tendency, once they get to the wall, to not go up. Alright, so how much we've reduced this by? 25. Right, you need to push this way, my friend. You need to push here, so. Okay, these towers have nearly been eliminated, I would imagine. Everyone's sitting at the back here just fine. And my Skaven slaves need to be continuing to push upon the initiative. Right, let's go with Clan Maul's here, get that bonus. Let's push up and over the walls quick, fast, and try and deal with the enemy. My siege towers are slowly but surely making their way up. Alright, how well are we doing further at the back here, trying to deal with those catapults? We're getting a little bit overrun by slayers now coming into it. Okay, we're getting up over the walls here now as well, where we can.
Push for it, laddies. Yes, yes. Take the walls. Yes, yes.
Oh my god, we're getting smashed by arty fire a little bit. Okay, so how well is everyone else pushing up here still? You need to push for this. You need to push for that unit. You're still going up here. We have a 37%. So that's about what it was quite a few other times. Right, come on. Let's get up over the walls and pick a unit and kill them. Okay, we've got another menace below here. Oh, it's their catapult. Yeah. Stop them. They've dismounted from their catapults, but we're going to be able to eliminate them. At least one lot at least, which is fantastic. Okay, how is everyone else doing here? My reinforcements have now arrived, so get up on the walls where you can. Okay, continue to let my battering ram go for there. I'm going to get my... Okay, we need to slow this down a bit, so because my reinforcements have arrived. So you need to deal with this. You need to deal with this. Get you guys up and over the walls as quickly as possible. Like, go. Just go, gadget. Get you guys up this way as well. You deal with something like this, you deal with something like that. Perfect. Okay, get my catapults and stuff to halt, and then toggle fire at will. So they have no other towers under their control. Is there something we could maybe shoot up over the back here? The warp throwers might be able to do something over the top, but lightning, I'm not entirely sure. Right, my battering ram has now made its way. And the gateway will fall. Let's move my rat ogres straight through the breach, along with my two legendary lords. Okay. So what's happening at the back here? We've still got a unit operating, and they still have a unit of catapults. If we could sort of drag them away, that would be ideal. So we need to take the walls first, before we push down through here. Oh, looks like their lord might actually come out. Interesting. Oh, he's going to go up on the walls at least. Okay, good. We're dragging that away. They're leaving a unit of slayers there, which is unfortunate. Okay, everyone's now pushing through the breach. Come on, go for it. Oh, my warp throwers are actually shooting up over the top quite well there. Yeah, keep up the offensive then. Keep it up. Okay, so we don't have too many just sort of sitting down through there. So get the rat ogres to absolutely push through the breach and wreck shop. There we go. Push through. Give them hell. Yeah, there we go. We want them causing carnage. Okay. Let's push here then. We've got a lot more menaces below. Yeah, it's just that catapult, isn't it? Okay, right. Continue to deal with these gunners. Oh, my catapults are now moving up. Alright, get you guys to form up here and then do some sort of fire at will. We've got our own skirmishers here, which I have kind of neglected just a bit. Okay, we'll try and fall you two here, and then like you two there, and we'll try and break this up a bit. Alright. Still get the generals to hit this. How are we going casualty-wise? So we've lost about 1,000, they've only lost about 200. Okay, we just need to get behind this. So maybe we can cause a rout here, hitting them from behind. That's what we need to do. We need to sort of start flanking them a bit. Okay, they're still holding on the walls incredibly well here. Good, we've nearly eliminated them. Because this was a major cause for concern. If we could somehow get rid of their commander, that would be ideal. Try and get the rat ogres around the side here, potentially. Because you really want to be hitting them around the back. 9 seconds and we can get these guys surrounded. Because that surrounding knife did work. Having them there, allowing them to fire, has worked. We'll send in some more reinforcements here. Okay, like moving them this side. That might flank and get rid of them. Alright, push. Let's throw down some more buffs. Okay, good. We've routed them on the walls. Perfect. Make sure to try and kill as many of them as possible. These menace below flanking units work really well. I push for something like this. You push for that. Right, continue where you can. Okay, there's no units. There's no... Oh, I was going to say. I was hoping to see a unit... I was hoping to see a catapult unit on its own. But my catapult's actually firing quite well up into the back of that. Okay, we've nearly gotten the walls under our control. Nearly. We've got a couple more vermin there. They're dealing with them fine. Okay, let's utterly break this central unit here. It's going to be able to free up a hell of a lot of men. Rat men, rather. Man, you got to give it to the dwarves. They're doing a heroic final stand. But as you can see, the auto resolve wasn't as cracked up as it was meant to be. Now, let's move like Queek and everyone else further up this way. Their iron hammers are doing well. My skirmishers are getting some good support here, even though they're slaves. Okay, so we're still going to be able to beat them here today. We're going to be able to get them. Even though they're fighting to the bitter end. We're going to throw another menace below here. All they've got further at the back there are slayers, and we can deal with them fine. There's only one unit here on the walls that's actually holding anyway. Everyone else is just routing. Looks like they're moving those slayers up. Alright, we've got one more lot of menace from the below. Should we try and hit this side? They're routing. We want to try and hit this side here. That isn't, which is holding fast. Try and push, pin them in place. Okay, still dealing with them. Right, push there. Come on, there mustn't be many more left in here. We've completely and utterly surrounded the Dowie there. Looks crazy. They've just made a really solid shield wall. They're still dealing with some of the remnants there of the grudge throwers. Okay, we've got another menace below here, but we might allow the slayers to get surrounded. Right, push for them. Now send a unit in. There we go. We're about to get a really nice slayer surrounding. Send in the ogres, that'll be fine. Everyone else is still dealing with them. Good, their front line's been completely smashed now. It's just the left and center there. Come on, let's finish them off. Victory! We're going to have victory here today. Come on, let's finish off the Dowie. I think it's only them holding anyway now. Even those guys are wavering. It's just the slayers here in the center. We could send one unit to the town square there then. Right, let's get everyone else to halt now, my artillery. Try and finish off the Slayers here. The guys on the walls are now dead. Yeah, but that auto resolve was definitely like 95 to 90 in their favor. It just shows you how crazy the auto resolve is. But our rat ogres just absolutely wreck shop. Let's finish off the surrounded Dowie here. The last of the poor bastards. But that's it. She's soon to be all over Red Rover. That's all she wrote. Karak, Kadrin, Thorgrim, Grudgebearer, the man in the wheelchair. We're about to take his house. Along with his legs. Alright. 21, come on. Maybe just sort of reform a bit and then crush him again. That might do it. They're still goddamn holding on. Alright, let's get my Skaven Slingers to now halt. Disable fire at will. They're probably causing a decent amount of friendly fire. However, they're only slaves anyway. So, it didn't really bother me. But victory! We have victory here today. We deployed 6,530 to the garrison's 1,461. And we've taken Karak Kadrin. Even though the dwarves have 15 settlements up in the Silver Road, they now have one less. Come on. Let's finish them off. Rip them to pieces. Alright, let's end it on that then. Close victory, supposedly. Okay, okay. Alrighty, so we lost 508. Warp lost 1,146. Steelbeard lost his entire garrison, of course. So let's have a look who were the MVPs. What did most of the work? Oh, wow. That grudge thrower, 536. That was aiming at the Skaven slaves, wasn't it, though? 237 with the Slayers. What else did one? 147 with the long beards. Queek did 36. Our plague catapults didn't do too bad. Our rat ogres really broke up their lines and formation. 121 there. 55, 61. Storm vermin. And halberds did pretty poor, but they didn't really need to. It was really the rat ogres needing to be the MVPs because they are just such a good unit. I can't rate them enough. As of the start of 2019, stuff gets patched and nerfed often. I think they rebuffed the Doom Wheel in this latest update, and they also made most of the I think in the Vortex campaign, Queek doesn't start off with a catapult now; he starts off with a warp cannon because these catapults are incredibly strong compared to the warp cannon. But situationally, this campaign, it's been incredibly useful for us. Would have preferred a catapult, but still did quite well. Okay, guys, welcome to the campaign map. We have taken Karaz Karak, 15 food, a decent haul as well. How much wealth are we going to steal? Whoa, a whopping 4,000 for Queek. And we've shot up to a rank 14th as well. Cool, cool. So, we're going to loot and occupy this. Wow, we can upgrade it to a settlement button 5. How much is it going to cost us? How much food? Alright, let's do that. Let's make it a rank 5 so we can absolutely build the best and high quality Skaven equipment. Skaven engineers. So, Karaz Karak belongs to Clan Moors. Yes, yes. Oh my god, so we're going to be having... Oh, look at this. We're actually going to be able to hit most of our stuff here. Wow, the Black 13. We can really push up and maybe even get, like, Hell Pit Abominations. Doom Wheels as well. Fantastic stuff. Let's chuck a quick save on that. And we have 11k in the bank. I would be curious to see if the dwarves would sue for peace for a time. No, I imagine taking Thorgrim Grudgebearer's home would sort of piss him off. So they've got territory further in the north, further in the south there. Ah, they actually own what's-his-face Blight now. They must have confederated... Skaven Blight. They must have confederated with Ironhammer. I wonder if that's shot us up with Clan Pestilence now. No, it hasn't, so we can't confederate with them. Okay, guys. Well, unfortunately, on that note, I'm going to put a pin in the campaign here. I'm going to end the series here, potentially. I'm going to stop recording more episodes. I'm going to have a break for a couple of days, move on to another recording. I'll check back sort of the feedback, the comments, the general consensus. I always keep my saves, so guys, I can't stress this enough. This is make or break. If you want more quick episodes from now on, all you need to do is leave the video a like, subscribe, and sort of comment. Just show your support on the video. And we'll do more episodes. If not, I'm probably going to move on to another Total War Warhammer campaign. Or maybe another strategy game on the channel. I feel like we've sort of hit a sort of short victory. We've set out what I really wanted to achieve. I had a lot of fun with this campaign. But really, we could really push and just do whatever we want now. We could kind of snowball a bit. We've taken Karaz-Karak, which is a massive achievement for Queek. It's a fantastic settlement. The Mountain King's home. Look at this. We've got control of all this. I'm quite surprised that he doesn't have that sort of strong of the, doesn't occupy much of the Silver Road. Kind of surprises me. We've got our five territories down in Karak, eight peaks. Like, we could really push against the Greenskins quite easily. Maybe get rid of Ironhide if that's something you guys would like to see. We've gone and taken Karaz-Karak, of course. We've taken Karak, eight peaks, and destroyed the Crooked Mountain. We've also managed to behead and kill Skarsnik and Queen Kalidia of Lybaris. So unfortunately, on that note, it's time to end it here. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more Let's Play videos on the channel in general. My name has been Simsy. Take care. Unfortunately, guys, it is time to end the video here. Thank you very much for watching. Like and subscribe if you haven't already. Let me know in the comment section down below your feedback for the series. And if you'd like to see more, that's the best way to ensure more content. Leave a dislike if you're not enjoying the series. Check out my social media links if you want to stay connected with me. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, all in the description below. Highly recommend Twitter. Every single time I post a video, a tweet goes out. It's much more reliable than the YouTube subbox. These days, to get all the notifications for the channel, you have to click the bell, of course, to join the notification squad. I do enjoy reading those comments. Patreon and merchandise link in the description below, along with the Steam group. Come and join the community on Steam. And on that note, unfortunately, I have to end the video here. Thank you very much for watching once again. Make sure to take care of yourselves. Go out and have a fantastic rest of your day. My name has been Simsy. Goodbye. Really close cinematic shots here, pushing through the bridge. Oh, look at... That was probably the shot of the video there.